And then we had Easter, and now it's the 50th day since Easter, showing that the resurrected life is just that little bit better than the Lenten life, and that's for sure. Today also marks a milestone, at least personally. Since I became your rector, we have had 10 baptisms, I mean 10 funerals, which I lament and wish that hadn't been the case. But today we're taking the baptisms up to 13. So a good thing. And we have 2 weddings on the horizon as well. So the spirit is alive and active. We are bucking the trend. If Christianity seems to be dying out, we're going the opposite direction. The spirit is here and is with us. And it is an uncomfortable thing that we celebrate today. The calling of the Holy Spirit is a very un-Episcopalian thing. We are often called God's frozen chosen that you two are about to join into. And the Holy Spirit is quite the opposite, depicted as metaphors of fire, of great wind, of out of control things, of things that we can't grasp. I personally love this side of the Holy Trinity, the aspect of God that we don't even know how to make a statue of, or to draw a picture of, or even how to explain. A part of God that is breath, is wind, is inspiration, respiration, is life, something we can't quite grasp and brings change. And again, welcome to the Episcopal Church. You're joining not just God's frozen chosen, but a breed of people that hate change. I don't like it either, but it is where we feel God moving and calling us to wake up, to grow, to change. And we are in the midst of that. We want to make God a statue and like a God up on Mount Olympus, not moving on some throne with a big beard. But this is God young and alive and active and bringing a new breath of life to us and calling us into all sorts of bizarre directions and asking us to do things we may have never thought to do before. We're going to hear in these readings so many different kind of themes and metaphors, but one of the strongest you're going to hear in the first reading is, and I have to say, whoever the first reader is, you have our sympathy. This is one of those readings everybody just dreads. But Parthians, Medes, Elamites, Mesopotamians, Judeans, Cappadocians, we're sorry, it's in the Bible, but we will be very understanding. We probably don't know how to pronounce it either. But that is not a bad thing with this reading, because one of the themes in this is that when the Holy Spirit descended on all the apostles and Saint Mary and the disciples, they started speaking in different languages. Now again, Episcopalians, this kind of glossolalia speaking in tongues thing makes us and our English demeanor really uncomfortable. But there's a message behind it, that at the Tower of Babel, when we tried arrogantly to build a bridge up to heaven, the outcome of that was a disbursement, or maybe an acknowledgement of all of our divisions, where if you've ever had the experience where you can't communicate with somebody because you don't share the same language, you feel divided, misunderstood. And this is the fixing of the Tower of Babel, or Babel, whichever you prefer to call it. And hence the word babbling, especially babies speak it very well, that all of a sudden God has fixed the division. What was scattered has been unified. The symbolism of division to unity is also what we're celebrating in baptism this morning. The second reading I want to draw attention, oh, one more in the first. Again, a very Episcopalian thing. Also, we are sometimes called Whiskeypalians. And St. Peter is going to say, you think all the apostles are drunk, but I'm telling you it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. They're not drunk yet. Enough said on that one. Then the second reading from St. Paul to the Romans, just a couple more of those beautiful metaphors I want to draw attention to, that the whole creation, especially when we're celebrating a sacrament of birth, St. Paul describes the whole of creation, not just earth, but the whole universe, as groaning in labor pains until now, and groaning inwardly. And then the Spirit comes, the breath, the life, the first breath of life, which is where inspiration, Spirit comes from, breathing life into the clay. And all of a sudden, the Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. The beauty of the poetry of what we're going to hear, I don't want to get past you without notice. And then finally, the gospel, Jesus, where it always, all of this leads. Our baptism is a beginning, a step into that water, like Jesus, into his grave and being resurrected, coming up out of that grave in white, given a name and welcomed into a community. Again, the division, the scattered, is brought into one, into unity with God. And Jesus saying, I know you're going to be sad that I'm leaving today, but I'm sending you the Holy Spirit. I know you're scared that this is a lot of change, that this isn't how you imagined God or religion or whatever it may be, but I am sending you the Spirit, also called the Comforter. The one who takes all of our Episcopalian anxiety about change and going into something we don't know, like the first steps into the Christian life, of forgiving and loving and paying attention to the marginalized. We are told we have the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, who is both mighty and the most gentle to guide us, to inspire us, to lead us, to become more and more like Christ. And this is going to turn, he says, your whole worldview upside down. You thought you knew what sin was. You're about to learn it's a whole different thing. You thought you knew what righteousness was. You're about to see it's totally different. And so is judgment. Judge not, lest ye be judged. Welcome everyone into the church. The Spirit was there for all nations, not just for us versus them. It's not just Episcopalians versus all the rest of the world. It is, we are joining in the unity where the Spirit has guided us. Now, enough from me babbling on this. Let us now listen as God unifies our scattered thoughts.
When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them, and all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And as this sound and the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one of them heard them speaking in the native language of each, amazed and astonished, they asked, Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? How is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and parts of Libya, belonging to Cyrene and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds and power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them. "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days, it will be God declares that you will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters will prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show portents in the heaven above, signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. And the sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon to blood. Before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day, then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The word of the Lord.
A reading from Paul's letter to the church in Rome. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is in the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Advocate, the Comforter, comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You also are to testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you, but now I am going to him who sent me. Yet none of you asks me, 'Where are you going?' But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment. About sin, because they do not believe in me. About righteousness, because I'm going to the Father, and you will see me no longer. About judgment, because the ruler of this world has been condemned. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
extremely good, brothers and sisters. In wonder and gratitude, let us pray, saying,
You send forth your Spirit, come Holy Spirit. Holy God, by your Spirit you gave birth to your church. May our many members be the one body of Christ in this world. Give to each member of your church the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. You send forth your Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Holy God, you gave your disciples the ability to speak in the languages of the people. May we also speak about your deeds of power throughout the world, that all may know of your salvation. You send forth your Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Holy God, the earth is full of your creatures. May all who look to you be given food in due season. Open your hand in desolate places and fill the hungry with good things. You send forth your Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Holy God, you poured out your Holy Spirit in your holy city, Jerusalem. Pour out your Spirit in our own city. Raise up prophets and dreamers. Give us vision. Send forth your Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Holy God, you give the gift of healing by your Spirit. Bring healing and wholeness to all those on our hearts and minds this day. You renew the face of the earth. Bring renewal to those in need, especially Tammy, Terry, Andrew, Joni, Chantal, Laura, Kevin, Sally, May, Monty, Lauren, George, Chuck, Linda, Larry, and Keith. You send forth your Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Holy God, we pray for our sisters and brothers who were baptized into the one body, who were made to drink of the one Spirit, and who now have died in Christ, especially Jay, Don, and Peter. May those who have called upon your name, O Lord, be saved forever. You send forth your Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
For what else shall we pray?
Lee about to be baptized.
This church and its congregation.
Let us all pray together. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Now, if I may invite the parents and godparents and those to be baptized, come forward. Wherever's comfortable. Wonderful, you all ready? Have you been enjoying your last few minutes of being a pagan? Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are all buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him to newness of life. I call upon you to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and all his works and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Parents and godparents, will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life? If so, say, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help these children to grow into the full stature of Christ?
I will with the help of God.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? If you do, say, I renounce them.
Right.
If you don't, just go quiet. Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? If you do, say, I do.
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
Will all you who witness these vows do everything in your power to support these children in their life in Christ?
We will.
Let us now, would you please stand and let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. And so I ask you all, do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace amongst all people and respect the dignity of every human being? Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Now to the fun part. Ready? The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your Son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship all those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we beseech you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who hear are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Name this child.
Olive.
ready? Holly Lee, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We receive Holly Lee into the congregation of Christ's flock and do sign her here with the sign of the cross in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. You were sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's son forever. Here we go. Yeah, find that microphone. Our Lord Jesus Christ made the deaf hear and the dumb speak. May he see and touch your ears to receive his word, and your mouth to proclaim his praise to the glory of God Almighty. It works. All is well now. Name this child.
E-N,
I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We're almost done. We receive B.N. into the congregation of Christ's flock and do sign her here with the sign of the cross in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forevermore. Our Lord Jesus Christ made the deaf hear and the dumb speak. May he soon touch your ears to receive his word and your mouth to proclaim his faith to the praise and glory of God the Father. Amen. To the godparents. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. These children of yours have now been enlightened by Christ. They are to walk always as children of the light. May they keep the flame of faith alive in their hearts, and when the Lord comes, may they go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Dearly beloved, these sisters have now been reborn in baptism. They are now called children of God, for so indeed they are. Let us welcome the newly baptized into the church. We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
Good morning and a blessed Pentecost to each and every one of you. Good morning, everyone. Good morning.
There's Catherine.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning, everybody.
Happy Whit Sunday.
Happy Whit Sunday.
Spirit helps us in our weakness,
for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words.
Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God. Worship and praise belong to you, author of all being. Your power sustains, your love restores our broken world. You are unceasingly at work, from chaos bringing order and filling emptiness with life. Christ raised from the dead proclaims the dawn of hope. He lives in us that we might walk in light. Your spirit is fire in us. Your breath is power to purge our sins and warm our hearts to love. As children of your redeeming purpose, freed by him who burst from the tomb and opened the gate of life, we offer you our praise with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory. Thanksgiving be to you, Lord of all. For by the cross, eternal life is ours, and death is swallowed up in victory. In the first light of Easter, glory broke from the tomb and changed the women's sorrow into joy. From the garden, the mystery shone clear that he whom they had loved and lost is with us now in every place forever. Making himself known in the breaking of the bread, speaking peace to the fearful disciples, greeting fishermen on the shore, he renewed the promise of his presence and of new birth in the Spirit, who sets the seal of freedom on your sons and daughters. Before he was given up to suffering and death, recalling the night of Israel's release, the night in which slaves walked free, at supper with his disciples, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body. It is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Made one with him, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us, and upon this bread and this wine, that overshadowed by your Spirit's life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son, and we may be kindled with the fire of your love and renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us, who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's body, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love, until at last, in your new creation, we enter into our heritage in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. And now, as Christ our Savior himself has taught us, so we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy and life-giving God, you have broken the bread which is Christ's body. We have tasted the wine of his new life. We thank you for these gifts, by which we are made one in him and drawn into that new creation, which is your will for all the world. Through him who died for us and rose again, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Would you please be seated if you were kneeling? And Sunday school. Oh, my cheat sheet. Marvelous. What was your favorite part of the story? Okay, you want to think. What was your favorite part of the story?
My favorite part was seeing all the disciples.
Cool. Which one's your favorite? Do you have a favorite yet? Okay. I change. Sometimes, because you get to know them kind of like real people, and then you decide, I don't know, I want to have dinner with that one, but I would like to with that one. Okay, what do you think, actually with you, what do you want to tell us? You can make up your own question. Yeah, show us what you mean.
Blah, blah, blah.
What is it?
Yeah, I know, that was the sermon with blah, blah, blah. Oh, you were listening, you were paying attention, you memorized my sermon. That's great. So what do you think it's like to receive the Holy Spirit?
Blah, blah, blah.
Speaking in tongues. Well done. And another one. They're all speaking in languages we can't understand. Okay, so... Yeah. In other announcements, the main thing is congratulations to the newly baptized and parents and godparents, and our promise of prayers and support, and you get a lifetime warranty. If you need anything, please come. And to those who are visiting, please know we have a policy of no judgment. If there's anything we can ever do for you, we are not in the business of excluding, but in the business of uniting and drawing together. So please don't hesitate to let us know if we can ever be of service to you. I'm not going to bother reading all these announcements because I'm pretty sure you can all read. But I know I need to draw attention to the Austrian choir is coming to us in the fall, and our choir master is a little nervous that we don't have enough places to house 30 choristers, mostly adults. So if you can email me or the wardens or Lucas, if you've got a guest bed or a sofa or a chicken coop, whatever you've got, we'll be glad. Are there birthdays or anniversaries to celebrate?
Can I say something?
Yes.
There is a brunch afterwards. Originally, it was going to be a pancake kind of breakfast, but it's not. It's bagels and assorted things, and a cake for the baptist.
Newly
baptized.
Baptized. Wonderful. So, cake, breakfast, it all sounds very low carb and low calorie. But we hope everybody will join us afterward to keep this festival going. Are there any other announcements I'm forgetting? Then would you please stand? Go out into God's world, filled with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Let love guide your actions. Listen for the Spirit of truth. Spread the peace of Christ and remind everyone you meet that each one is a beloved child of God. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you all and remain with you forevermore.
Thank you.
May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
And
go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia.
And a blessed Pentecost to you. We will see you.